two pieces and then maybe one quick short one that's like four lines long that I think is kind of funny. And yeah, I'll just kind of jump right into them. And I might, well, you know what, I'll share my screen if anyone wants to follow along with the text itself. Sometimes I do some fun little wordplay in there that you can't necessarily see unless you read it. So let me do that. Hey, there I am. Okay, so this first one is literally called something. I don't have a great title for it, and so I'm just calling it something for the time being. Yeah, let's just get right into it. I am one in my humanity. You are two in yours. Conjoined, our trinity drips hot like holy oil. Three in heaven, three in hell. Burning slip through basket gaps. Tears in a wicker bed that scald our spun materials. Soaked by and soiled, we wring ourselves. Inner moisture rot for the world roots. Do you hear it groan its epoch? Do you see its autumn taking turn, bowing with its progeny? I would love you in this tree. I would love to see the forest nourished by our drain. An acorn cracks. Inside, another acorn. Unaccustomed noonfall splitting bodies on a stone, the uproot truth of you, the other innards peering through cracks of twice-tilled provision, the tragic wan of sick and wasted sucker. You either stay awake or wait, bedreamed, eaten by your expectation. And I might call it something beautiful, and you could call me poet. And I'll shrink, because while some can name and some can praise, I think only of the way you move in mountain shadow. And I'm sorry, but there are no names for that. Thank you. So that's my first one. Mm-hmm. Gotta get a little of that liquid courage in there. I'm gonna briefly mention that I also run a poetry critique circle here in Seville, and so if you ever want to come and check us out, we meet every other Tuesday for about 2 hours and talk about our poems and do some helpful critique and things like that. I'll post my email in the chat, and you can take that, shoot me an email if you want to join, check us out, or if you want, just send me a private email or private chat on here and with your email address, and I'll try to add you. And then I have one other announcement right after this, but I'll just go ahead and read this one next. So I also like to do a lot of rhyme. I do some sonnets. I do a little bit of everything, but this is just a new rhyme. It's called Pharmacon. And it blends a bunch of different things I was reading at the time. It blends a little bit of Jacques Derrida and his concept of the Pharmacon from the Platonic Dialogues. It blends a little bit of Consider the Lobster by David Foster Wallace, a little bit of Dante. It's just all over the place, kind of tackling things that create their own problems. You can see it from the text itself. So anyway, I will go ahead and read that. Pharmacon. Love may sow the germ of things that bloom too bright within, but equally it pollinates the pistol whip of sin. Preference bolsters daily through the pharmacy of choice, but it also grunts of suffering in its second voice. Dante saw a million lovers eased and damned the same. Those tenets trapped in hell are lobsters by another name. So shut the lid and shut their mouths unless they mean to scream. Better meet the boiling quick than suffer along the steam. Boredom too's a sprouted thorn we quicken to condemn. It pricks its picker bloody when they grasp excitement's stem. Or worse, the stippled petals rot in pasto in the sun, blend by boring brushstrokes to a streaking shade of one. Orgasmic is the singer, but better is the band. The concert might just numb you if you watch it second hand. Would any acclamation catch and trip you unawares, but just a single step does not make a flight of stairs. And what are words but remedies to symptoms they create? Salvation in the sickness as expectations actuate. Blindness comes from seeing, deafness falls from sound. Greater is the mystery from answers that are found. Always chasing voices, the lotus drug ideal, when everything is actual It's actually unreal.
Thank you.
And then I might just do one really quick short one. I'm going to scroll down to it wherever I put it. This one actually is going to appear in my new book, which will be coming out hopefully next year. I'm finishing the editing now. It's called The Gastrolith. It's all about those things that we cannot process, but help us process other things themselves. And it's called Eat Right. So I'm just going to do it super fast. I figure I'd just tag it on here at the end. Eat right. You may be tempted to say something like, you don't eat right. And I may be tempted to respond with, I don't eat, period. But let's face it, we won't say either because we're too goddamn polite and thin. Thank you. And actually, I wanted to make one more announcement. I'm also teaching a class at Writer House about poetry composition. It's called Explorations in Imitation, Using Poetry to Communicate the Incommunicable. It'll be starting in January. And so if you want to learn about, you know, looking into some alternative styles of poetry, maybe something that you've not tried before, definitely check it out. I will post the link in the chat if anyone wants to look at it. And yeah, there we go. Oh, wait, whoops. Let me do that. Okay, I'm done. Thank you.